Alex Ovechkin, the greatest goal scorer of this generation, at age 33, and already one of the greatest players to ever play the game. And we're here to ride the wave.
He's this individuality that is really just Alexander Ovechkin. And he's developed his own brand. It really is contagious.
Ovechkin is a person who individually you fear because of what he's able to do with the puck.
You see that explosive passion in here when he plays. In fact, whole family is hooked up.
But where did it all start? When did he become a superstar? How did he become a superstar? Born on September 17th, 1985, Alex grew up in Moscow, Russia, where he loved to play hockey. Ovechkin would play hockey all day long, and at night he would watch his favorite player, Mario Lemieux. And in 2004, the Washington Capitals franchise would change forever.
The Capitals would draft Alexander Ovechkin.
The Washington Capitals are pleased to select Alexander Ovechkin.
I was not surprised. I'm expected to be number one. I have one dream. I follow this dream all the time. So when I come here to NHL, I just want to be the best, and I do my best.
And Ovechkin was at his best. Ovechkin was a star for the Capitals, and it was demonstrated when he scored his first goal.
Shaded there by Rick Nash. Dinos Zubris spins. Ovechkin fires. He scores. Alexander Ovechkin, welcome on board.
The rookie year was dazzling. So much flash and dash and speed and power. He was the biggest car in the demolition derby and wanting to crash into everybody.
The then 20-year-old Ovechkin, 3 months into his first season, scored a goal like no other.
And Alexander Ovechkin curl and drag to the back end. He scores! Simply sensational!
To do what he was able to do, the dexterity with which he shows, to cradle that puck while sliding into the corner, while on his back and on his neck, and to contort his arm to get that shot to the cage, it was remarkable.
I was just in amazement. I was in shock.
It was actually stunning. It was a stunning goal. Wayne Gretzky's the coach in Arizona, and you look over after this goal, and Wayne Gretzky's looking at the Jumbotron, and you see this look on his face like, wow.
When Alex is on the ice, and especially in that rookie season where it seemed like every other day he was producing high drama and an amazing highlight, you had to stay with that play because it looked like the one-on-one rush had ended and that he had been defended well.
So when I'm down, I just said, you must shoot, and I shoot it, but my shoot was not perfect.
It was remarkable.
To the back end, he scores! Simply sensational!
My own perspective, the goal forever stands out to me as one of the very best.
With Ovechkin finishing with 52 goals and 106 points, Ovechkin took home the Rookie of the Year trophy.
Ovechkin, a one-man highlight reel, 106 points, led all rookies in scoring.
And the Calder goes to
Alexander Ovechkin.
First of all, I want to say thanks, Sydney and John. Great season. You're great players, guys, and good luck in the future.
Alex's second season as a Capital was great as well, finishing with 46 goals and 46 assists, leading his team in points with 92. But it was a poor season for the Capitals, not making the playoffs. But with this season, they ended at the bottom of the charts. They got a high draft pick. In 2006, the Capitals would draft a player strictly designed for assisting Ovechkin, Nicholas Backstrom. And in Ovechkin's third season, he scored his 100th goal.
Nice move into the zone by Green, then he was bumped. Chance for Ovechkin, he scores! That's all he needs! Number 100 of his NHL career in 167 games. That's the fastest since Eric Lindros.
In the same year, Ovechkin finished with a career high of 65 goals, adding up to a total of 112 points, which he took home the Art Ross Trophy, the Ted Lindsay Award, the Hart Memorial Trophy, and the Maurice Richard Trophy for the first time in his career. And Alex Ovechkin was proving to hockey fans why he was a superstar. In the same year, the Capitals would make the playoffs, and it would be the first time Ovechkin would be in the playoffs. And was he ready to play?
With 4 minutes left to go. And you said green means go up. It's in. Ovechkin scores. There it is. His first Stanley Cup playoff goal. And it's a go-ahead goal for Washington.
And they go off the stick of Ovechkin. In comes Ovechkin. On the breakaway. Ovechkin alone. Scores! Alex Ovechkin is back. And the Caps have the lead. Coburn can't get that by Fedor across the goal. Ovechkin scores! Two for Ovechkin in the third, and it's 4-2 Washington.
Quick strike, and he was screaming that he wanted.
Flyers did a really good job of not chasing in behind the net.
Here's Ovechkin with a kick. He scores! Alexander the Great does it again.
But in a Game 7, winner takes all. The Flyers were too much, and they defeated the Capitals. Alex Ovechkin would go home for the first time in his career. A playoff
Alexander
loss.
Ovechkin going through the,
In the offseason, Alex was offered a 13-year, $124 million contract, which he negotiated with his parents. He was now the highest-paid player in NHL history. And the next season for the Washington Capitals and Alex Ovechkin, Ovechkin was incredible. Every time he got the puck, again, it was in the net. He finished with 56 goals and was becoming a superstar.
That's insane.
What makes Alex a superstar?
Superstar!
Over the top. Electric. Eccentric.
He's a rock star.
Ovechkin can skate, shoot, hit. He does it all.
Every game is like his last game, and I love that about watching him.
It's good to be Ovi.
And yes, it is good to be Ovi. Alex Ovechkin, of course. And now he's the face of the Washington Capitals. With Ovechkin finishing with 56 goals, he was the leading scorer the second year in a row, which was remarkable. Alex Ovechkin was now becoming a superstar the Capitals have always wanted, and now he was meeting famous players from the Washington Redskins and even famous players from the NBA.
Alex Ovechkin is probably the number one, arguably the best player in hockey right now.
How much? What kind of style does he play with?
Reckless abandon. If he sees point A, he wants to get to point A, no matter what's in the way. So he's going there.
Hamrick can't get there. What a move by Ovechkin about Hamrick. In comes Ovechkin. In front. What a goal by Alexander Ovechkin. Unstoppable.
Every arrow for us is up. The worst economy in my lifetime. Revenues are going to be up maybe 40% this year. Attendance is up well over 30%. We will sell out every single game for the playoffs and all of next season.
With Ovechkin's rough and physical style of play, Ovechkin was looked down on by a lot of former NHL players because of his over-top celebration and his celebration of goals. Former NHL player Don Cherry had some words to say about Alex Ovechkin's celebration.
He was acting like an idiot, jumping around. I tried to tell him, don't do it. I'm going to tell you about this guy. He's got a free ride. He runs it, guys, does this stuff. I am predicting somebody's going to get him, and somebody's going to get him good.
He scores on his first shot of this game. And he's got a little celebration here. I'm sure Don Cherry will have a reaction to that.
Don Cherry was criticizing how you celebrated your 50th goal. What do you think?
Different minds.
Yeah.
Old people, you know, like, they're like when people show some energy, some emotions.
Right.
So they're like robots. You can go like this. You have to skate like this. Don celebration when you score goal. Thank you, Don.
Is that ever gonna be you?
Kidding me? No.
And in the first round of this season, the Capitals would play the Rangers, where Alex Ovechkin would score a goal almost every single playoff game, and the Capitals would win.
Before turning to Ovechkin and then to Backstrom, touched on across to Pody. Pody has Semin to his left, decides to crank one. Oh, and it deflected in. A tip in front. It's found its way into the net off Alexander Ovechkin, and it's five.
Now, it rolls in wide. There's no icing here. 4 seconds, three. Big hit attempt by Dubinsky, and the Washington Capitals.
And for the first time in Ovechkin's career, they would win their first playoff series. And the Capitals would move on and play the Pittsburgh Penguins. But there is another superstar, a young man like Alexander Ovechkin, but completely different style of play, Sidney Crosby.
They're both tremendous athletes. The thing I like the most about both of them is they love the game and they play with passion.
And Ovechkin and Crosby built up a rivalry. And the regular season with both of them was insane. Every time they both were out there, hits were being thrown, shots were turning into the goal, and Ovechkin and Crosby were playing insane. It wasn't only Ovechkin and Crosby who had a rivalry, it was the Capitals and the Penguins, one of the biggest rivalries in NHL history, and right now, it couldn't be much bigger.
I feel this team can win Stanley Cup. Nobody can beat us.
It was talked about for months if they would play in the playoffs, and they finally got the chance. The Capitals and Ovechkin quick got off to a 2-0 series lead, with Ovechkin having a hat trick in game two. But then the Penguins would battle back, winning the next three to make it a 3-2 series lead for the Penguins. And Ovechkin would go strong in Game 6 and force a Game 7 for Washington. And in Game 7, the Pittsburgh Penguins and the Capitals were dying to play to see who would win. But in the winner takes all Game 7, the Penguins were just too good, and the Capitals were defeated, eliminating them from the playoffs.
Crosby advances. Ovechkin and Washington are gone.
In the next year for the Capitals, Alex would finish with another 50-goal season and win the Conn Smythe. It was another great year for Alex, where he had a plus-minus of 45, one of the best we've seen in a long time, and Alex was ready for the playoffs. But unfortunately, in the first round of the playoffs, Alex Ovechkin would lose against the Montreal Canadiens, leaving the Capitals heartbroken again. The next year for the Capitals and Ovechkin was looking to redeem himself, and he was. He was hitting better and passing the puck better, but his goal scoring went down that year, only scoring 32 goals. In the playoffs against the Rangers, in round one, the Capitals and Alex Ovechkin were on fire. Alex Ovechkin was scoring crazy goals, and the Capitals would beat the Rangers and move on to play Tampa Bay in round two. But unfortunately, they got swept. In the next season, Alex would finish with 38 goals, which is impressive considering how hard it is to score goals in today's hockey game. He was fifth in place for goals that year. Alex Ovechkin's physical style of play angered young Sidney Crosby, and the rivalry continued. Ovechkin's rivalry with Sidney Crosby was continued into this season. Even though Ovechkin wasn't at the top of the list of stats, he was still considered one of the best, and maybe even the best. Sidney and Crosby and him were still rivals.
It's a healthy rivalry in an era night right now. It's sort of like Larry Bird, Magic Johnson, where you have Crosby and Ovechkin. I think people love watching that sort of confrontation that they have with each other.
If Ovechkin and Crosby are like Bird and Magic, there's no question Ovechkin is more like Johnson, all style.
He's crazy, he's wild, he's fun.
He doesn't shave, and he's missing a tooth, and his hair's all over the place, but somehow the girls, they just keep coming to him.
Hey, what's up? It's Alex Ovechkin. A couple weeks ago, we have some charity event, and I met the cutest little girl I ever seen.
Guess what?
Huh?
I was thinking my mom was not a good sushi.
Okay.
Okay? Tonight. Me and you, okay?
Oh my goodness! Mom, I have a Stussy!
That's his rookie jersey, right? It's a black one.
He's
everywhere, huh? Yeah. California. Hmm? It's good, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, pass on.
On the date?
I asked him and he said yes.
Yes.
And I saw him that day and he scared us the cool cats and like the whole team of us.
But now, it was playoff time, and Alex Ovechkin and the Capitals would play the Boston Bruins in round one, which they ended up winning the series. In the second round, they would play the New York Rangers. But in a game seven, they would lose in the second round once again. The next season for the Capitals was short-lived because it was the NHL lockout. But in the 48 games the NHL played, Ovechkin managed to score 32 in 48 games, leading the league in goals. In the playoffs, the same year, the Capitals would lose to the Rangers in a game seven in round one. In the next year, the Capitals would sign head coach Adam Oates to try to change things up. But unfortunately for the Capitals, they did not make the playoffs that year. But Ovechkin did, however, score 51 goals, making it his fourth time scoring 50 or more goals in a season. Ovechkin would be ready to play his next season. In Alex Ovechkin's next season with the Capitals, he scored 53 goals and had 28 assists, with a total of 81 points.
It's a new day, it's a new life. For me, and I'm feeling good. I'm feeling good.
With Ovechkin's 53 goal season, it helped the Capitals make the playoffs. In the first round, Ovechkin was on fire once again, scoring a couple goals, helping the Capitals make it to round two.
You know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life.
But periods of time when they couldn't seem to win any. This is fed in front of Ovechkin. He scores!
But unfortunately for a game seven, in overtime, the Rangers would score and win, moving on to the third round. Okay, but this should finally be the year for the Capitals. President's Trophy winner by a landslide, and proof death on the wing. God mows Evgeny Kuznetsov. A Vezina Trophy winner, goaltender, by the love of God, this has to be the year for the Capitals. Ovechkin would have another 50-goal season and score his 500th goal.
Welcome to the club, number 500.
And in the first round of the playoffs, the Capitals and Ovechkin were insane. They took a 3-0 series lead and would go on to play the Pittsburgh Penguins. But in this round, the Penguins would take a 3-1 series lead, and the Capitals would rally, forcing a Game 6. In that Game 6, it went to overtime, and the Penguins would score a goal in overtime to send them to the third round, leaving the Capitals with another overtime loss in the seventh game, Round 2.
Johnny, the wound obviously is very fresh. We've seen this far too often, so pardon me if I sound crushed. I am crushed because I believed there were a couple of instances in the third period where the Capitals defied death. They did. But the way Washington rallied is a sign that this is a different team. Please do not say the word collapse to me. Do not say the word choke to me. This is not one of those. This is a very good Pittsburgh team that's moving on to a conference final.
From Sidney Crosby and the Pittsburgh Penguins, and they will take on the Tampa Bay Lightning, and a second chance opportunity ends up in the back of the net.
It's now or never, don't surrender. We came too far to die.
So in the 2016-27 season, Alex Ovechkin's team just got better. He now had the complete pieces to make it to the end, and he would score his 1,000th point. But Ovechkin's age was starting to catch up with him, as he only scored 33 goals, which was still very impressive.
By Oshie, played back ahead of Backstrom, ahead now to Ovechkin, cruising on in, to Brady, score! 1,000 points!
With back-to-back President Trophy winners, the Capitals were looking to win it all. In the first round of the playoffs, Ovechkin was incredible. But unfortunately, in Game 4 of the first round, Ovechkin would take a painful hit.
Ovechkin's hit by Kadri, and he takes him down, and there's a penalty on the play, and Ovechkin is hurt. As you can imagine, the reaction by the Caps on the ice going right after first Kadri and then whoever else they can.
Unfortunately, Ovechkin's leg was really hurt and could not play any more games that series. But in the same series, the Capitals without Ovechkin would move on to play the Pittsburgh Penguins once again. But Alex Ovechkin was really hurt, but he made the trip and he would play on the third line, but he was very injured. But Alex Ovechkin, basically on one leg, still found the way to score in the playoffs. In round 2, game 7, the Capitals were unable to get past the second round of the playoffs once again, losing to the Penguins once again, and Ovechkin was frustrated and angry. Capitals fans were frustrated and angry. The owner was frustrated and angry. Thank you. There are even talks about trading Alex Ovechkin.
I think they should trade Ovechkin. I know that sounds insane, but he's tradable because he's only 31. He's still a hell of a player. You could get a lot in return for him. At some point, you know, I don't want to hear any stats. The best player has to take responsibility. And
changes are going to have to be made to the Washington Capitals because they cannot make it past the second round of the playoffs. And Ovechkin would now be 32.
Try to do our best.
In the offseason, the Caps would have to release quite a few players. They would release Justin Williams, Kevin Shattenkirk, and Carl Alsner, leaving a lot of gaps for rookies to play. Alex Ovechkin would have to lead his team, mostly by himself, to a Stanley Cup victory. In the first two games, Ovechkin scored 7 goals and having a hat trick in both of them. It was a year to remember for Alex as he scored his 600th goal.
Kuznetsov looking, Ovechkin drives it, and it's diving Hellebuck. Rebound, score! Alex Ovechkin still going strong, overpowering at 600.
Alex was the 20th player to score 600 goals and the 4th fastest to do it too. And here's what the owner and some other 600 goal scorers had to say.
Alex Ovechkin, we all love you and are grateful to you. Congratulations on this next milestone, 600 goals. It's fantastic, it's historic, but I see 700 and maybe 800 in your future.
Hi, Ovi, Yari Kuri here. Congrats on reaching 600. Welcome to the club.
Congratulations and welcome to the 600 club.
I just want to congratulate you on scoring 600 goals. It's really an incredible feat to have done it so soon in your career with so many years left. I wish you continued success. You've got such a passion for the game. It was great to play against you. It's great watching you play now. And I wish you many, many more goals, except when you play against the Toronto Maple Leafs. But you're a class act, you're a great guy, and you're great for the game of hockey.
Amazing accomplishment, and here's to many more.
Congrats on 600, that's amazing, an awesome achievement, and just proud to see you succeed and hope for many more.
I just want to say congrats on the 600 goal, what a great accomplishment, and it's been great to be a part of that and being in your team, so huge congrats again, enjoy, and I don't know, keep scoring. Why slow down?
Alex Ovechkin, soon after, had another milestone where he played his 1,000th game.
Alexander Ovechkin, welcome on board!
Holy jumping, you gotta be kidding me!
Alexander Ovechkin, tough shot, bullseye!
A play by Alexander Ovechkin!
Flash dive for goal number 5, Ovechkin fires and scores! Ovechkin's 4th is the game-winning 5th! Ovechkin backs off the wall! Goal for point number 500.
Point perfection.
Gorgeous. Score! What a play by Alex Ovechkin.
Ovechkin on the spot.
Oh, baby, what a goal by Alexander Ovechkin. Guess who's done it again? Ovechkin, history, the all-time franchise point leader. Alexander the Great. 900 points in a flash. Welcome to the
In the rest of the regular season, Ovechkin helped his team make the playoffs and scored 49 goals at age 32.
A lightning bolt 20 seconds into the game.
Welcome home, Washington Capitals here at Capital One Arena. What a way to start his fourth goal of the season.
When playoff season came around, the Capitals would be down in the series 2-0, but they would come back, winning the next three games and sending the Capitals one win away from moving past the first round.
Alexander Ovechkin to the flank again, this time Kuznetsov. Picked up by Ian Cole. Carlson, Ovechkin shot, scores! Alex Ovechkin is back two tonight. This one on the power play. The Capitals with a 3-1 lead.
In the second round, the Capitals would play their kryptonite, the Penguins. But Ovechkin wasn't just scoring now, he learned to start passing. And Braden Holtby in the defense were playing great. And Alex Ovechkin now had a chance to send the Capitals with a 2-1 series lead. Ovechkin and his Russian friend Kuznetsov were both now scoring goals against the Penguins. In a game 5, the series tied, Ovechkin, instead of scoring it, makes the right decision and passes it. And Alex Ovechkin only needed one more game to beat the Penguins and get past round 2 for the first time. And in overtime, the Capitals only needed one goal to move on. And Ovechkin would pass it to Kuznetsov to end it.
Defeated the Penguins in a playoff series. They celebrated in their old arena in Landover, Maryland. Don Beaupre was the winning goalie. William Clinton was president. Gas was $1.01, and Alex Ovechkin was 8. Orlov yet again. Head fake, moves to the slot, fended across in the one-time touch, and they score! Jay Beagle finally let it go, and it ricocheted in.
It was Ovechkin's first time making it to the third round of the playoffs, and he was incredible. It would be Kuznetsov to Ovechkin, then back to Ovechkin to Kuznetsov. These two would pass the puck to each other and score goals almost every single game in the playoffs. And in a Game 7, winner goes to the Stanley Cup Finals decision. Ovechkin scored a goal and would help his team reached the Stanley Cup Finals for the first time in his career.
Of Wales trophy will be presented for the 94th time. The last 36 years it's gone to a team reaching the Stanley Cup final from the East. And this celebration will
And now the Capitals and Ovechkin will be playing in the Stanley Cup Finals against the Vegas Golden Knights. And the Capitals and Ovechkin had the series tied, heading back to Washington, where Ovechkin was incredible. The Capitals would win both two home games and go back to Vegas with a 3-1 series lead. And Ovechkin doing what he does best, scoring a goal in this game.
Looking at his options. Dick Backstrom across to Ovechkin, he scores! Ovechkin, a power play goal, and Washington has the lead. Seconds after the McNabb penalty, just 36 seconds.
The Vegas Golden Knights would be forced to pull their goalie on one last chance. But the Caps would prevail, and they would win the 2018 Stanley Cup Finals.
Lord Stanley, and he is coming to Washington.
Capitals, you've had years of frustration, but here is the grandest celebration. You get to hoist the Stanley Cup. Alex Ovechkin, it's your honor. Come on up.
Alex Ovechkin now had his Stanley Cup, and now could be considered one of the best to ever play the game, and his legacy will now always be remembered as one of the best hockey players and pure goal scorers to ever play the game. At age 33, he still has a lot of hockey left in him, and it's going to be exciting to see what he can do. The 6'3", 240-pound left wing, who has scored 50 or more goals in 7 seasons, may be celebrated for his ability to put the puck in the net, but he can also do a lot more.
I think right now hockey is fast, physical. I like to be involved in the physical game. It's part of my game and a part of my success.
Raw, beastly power, not just in his shot, but the way he plays the game. When he wants to take over a game physically, there are few players that can run into him and stay on their skates.
He's a monster, that guy. He skates like the wind, too, and I don't know how he does it.
Crisscrossing, sidestepping a hit. What a move! Ovechkin's in! His chance!
He can shoot it from anywhere. Passes in his feet, and in front, behind. Strange angles, velocity puts behind it. That's why he's one of the best.
His ability to take pucks that aren't in your wheelhouse and turn them into real exceptional scoring chances, I think that's the underrated portion of his game.
Ovechkin has won awards and scored goals at a rate that few has matched in NHL history. He's won 3 Hart trophies as the league's MVP, 3 Ted Lindsay awards by the most outstanding player voted on by his peers, 7 Maurice Bouchard trophies as a top goal scorer, a Conn Smythe for the MVP of the playoffs, and his Stanley Cup champion ring.
At the pace that he scored for how long he's done it, it's just incredible.
Ovechkin rips, he scores! Number 500 for the grade eight.
So many things change, you know, everyone's scouted so well, everyone knows your tendencies, and he continues to score at, you know, crazy pace year after year.